าอีกเลยนะ
พี่ตรงนั้น
Thank you.
Very beautiful. been rode a driverless car. From the entrance going to the dome proper. There is a driverless thing. You're ahead of time. General welfare, the gender. This is now.
somebody took a picture of it.
This is.
Yeah,
that is it, right?
Yes.
You know, about a month ago and 2 years ago, you cannot see anything there. There's 116 structure, house, warehouse, venue. And I'm going to go to your house, in front of your house, Mr. Ambassador, can I ask your people, can you please clean up your plantains? You can tell me, excuse me, Mr. Mayor, can you please clean up your
own?
Your plantain, please, before you ask me. I will have moral ascendancy to ask you something, if I am for one. So this was taken away from the public for 6 straight years.
Wow.
And it took us 48 hours. This is an old part,
yes.
Now new part. Old new part.
Yes.
In fact, I was surprised to Manila. A matter of buildings. I will bring Manhattan, New York,
yeah.
In Manila. It's already there. That's why it said coming soon.
Uh-huh.
I have something.
Well, I see a Wi-Fi, which is something I saw this morning in the newspaper. I have to provide free Wi-Fi spots right around the city.
This is a New York concept.
Yeah.
That's why.
Wonderful.
When I told you a while ago, I keep copying things. I am copying things from Singapore, copying things, matter of policy from Mr. Lee, from New York, from whatever, anything that I saw that seems fit to our culture and tradition. We end up
with.
We put more trees. See that the back of Tambana,
yeah.
We call it that request from Paso. A few weeks ago, that's full of shit.
What do you mean it's full of shit?
Not metaphorically.
Literally.
Literally.
Extremely. Okay. So what do you do?
They clean it up.
Okay, yeah.
Put flowers, lightings, clean everything. Put policemen. There. Now people are walking. There's so much space now. So we put more plants. You see the green part?
Yes.
One week old.
Ah, okay. You just started planting.
Yes, and this one also. And as you can see, we are destroying cement from the previous obstruction, illegally constructed building. So we destroyed the cement. We are now taking care of the soil, making it more viable for plants. So in a matter of a few days, all those areas. Open areas. Plant more trees. This is 2 weeks old. This is 1 week old. The grass, the plants, and we put the give it back to the people. Basic.
Basic.
Nothing rocket science.
No, because I think it's you. I think because you have a will. The energy.
I think that's the secret of Mr.
To
sum it up.
It's a big deal, yeah.
Yeah.
It's true, yeah.
To sum it up.
Yeah.
That's why he was always being misconstrued. But if you read.
I think you're only accountable.
Tomorrow is Singapore Day.
Tomorrow is our national day. Yes, we celebrate our
60 years plus.
54.
Yeah,
it's still a young nation.
Wow. very young.
Very young.
It seems that it's been hundreds of years because of development. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
I'm happy for your independence. And all those, I remember a story that he said to me in his book. Third world, first world. There was a story there. There's so much anarchy in the streets. So he needed the soldier, but doesn't have money to fund armed soldier who is in the situation in the streets. There's so many rallies here, rallies there. The Hindus, the Malays, the Chinese. Keep on bombing each other. I think it was in the
60s.
He really knows how to utilize the fortune to protect his dealing with German, Americans, and British, how they utilize those opportunities. And one thing that I always do, I think that is the most significant.
It is a major component, yes, in how we develop ourselves. Because I think right from the outset, we knew that unlike most movies, we are not big. We don't have much.
You don't even know water. At the time, you borrow water from Malaysia.
You buy water.
Sure, it was
cheap. You purchase water.
Well, purchase, I mean, so.
Yeah, you purchase water. So, the most important resources are the why you involve civil education. I think sometimes you can see this for yourself around the world. Sometimes countries are blessed. Source curse because can fall back easily is actually insurance. Whereas people in situation where you are forced to fend for yourselves, you find innovative ways to survive and to lose. It's also part of the story. Yes.
You're very lucky.
Yeah, lucky. You're very good lucky. Leadership, and it does make a big difference. And I'm sure Mr. Ray, this is something. And we really wish you all the best of luck on this endeavor. As you know, Singapore, we have done some things in terms of city development. I mentioned this to you before. We always have to share our experiences. I understand we achieved stuff that when you're going to Singapore next year.
Invite the world cities.
Yeah.
I was supposed to come on July 11. I was asked by.
Right.
Brazil.
Ah, not Brazil, Colombia.
Medellin. But I respectfully declined for the simple reason I'm going to assume office on July 1. So it's like, you know, only one week after, now I'm going out of travel.
Yeah.
And there's so much problem here.
Yes.
So more than the things that I can learn in Medellin, Colombia, sponsored by Singapore, and I told to my friend David Newman, David, I'm really sorry for the son because I don't want. It's just that I'm ashamed to the people of Manila. I just assume all peace, and here I am traveling about 6,000 miles away from the city. So I respect you, but if you really wanted me to go and participate, I can come next year. And I think
next year's at Singapore, so it's not so far to travel.
Yeah, I received already the.
Yes.
Did you receive?
Yes.
So I'm going to Singapore.
Yes. So that's next year. And actually, it's what I understand is it's not a bad forum because you get a lot of the mayors around the world. Right? So all those things that you say before, I guess.
One of the prestigious conventions, any mayors in the world.
best ideas, the best for your city.
And I'm grateful to Singapore government for choosing me to participate. You're really trying to spend money for us, you know, just to share what you have learned, did in the past, and going to do in the future. So, I'm in advance, Your Excellency. Thank you very much.
No, I mean, actually, one of the things I wanted to see you about, because I know you can do it, there was so much.
I hope so.
So, we are glad that you are going to come for the whole city summit next year. But I think in the interview, what can you do? Can you give some conversations with your office? Mm-hmm. To tailor a study with your own office. We have a lot of expertise, as I said. I think she was staff is good friends with Dan Arara in the Aquinas School of Public Policy. They have a lot of ideas on waste management, water management, public policy, we have all these agencies who deal with this on a full-time basis. Companies, even traffic.
Yeah.
A while back, discussing.
I have a dream to really address flooding. Because
BUB can help.
I cannot transfer the country outside of the tropical area. So one thing for sure, out of 12 months, we're going to face rainy season. But if there's one good thing about that challenge, it's true, get flooding, but after the rain, things are okay. But the best goal is there's no flooding during the rainy or monsoon season in Manila. That's the goal. But I think in a million light years, we'll arrive there. But with your help, I really want to go to that direction with regard to our roads. Because we can always traffic in Metro Manila and Manila. It's literally a day-to-day thing.
Yeah.
Even though we were going to build vertical development, there will be traffic. It's always there, as always, because of economic movement, business are progressing, our GDP and inflation rate is doing better because of the president, and his cabinet, and so on and so forth. So traffic will be there day-to-day. What we can do with traffic is to manage it. Just manage it. So if before you travel from point A to point B at 2 hours, if I can give you 1.5 hours, that is what you call management. And better, it is 1 hour. Because as we speak, cars are being born, the manufacturing plant, but no roads are being born, created. So basic science, space occupied by matter, lesser space. So instead of arguing how to solve traffic, I think the best attitude is to manage traffic. Rules are being implemented properly and respectfully, with or without the enforcers. But flooding to me is non-negotiable. Why? Because this is
you can build your drainage system.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I was thinking when I was fortunate enough to speak before a group of U.S. Embassy yesterday.
Yes.
I told them, can you please study once and for all? I literally beg, not beg, but ask, can you please help us? I don't mind if it will take 3 years, 4 years, or 5 years to study the entire city, geographically speaking, so that we will have a road map of the underground, the city, how can we utilize our creeks, rivers, because creeks, rivers are assets of any LGU in a modern world. This is the most expensive property in the world. If you are by a creek, by a river, it's prime. But in our case, nobody wanted to stay there because there's so much filth in our river. So if we can redesign, redevelop our creeks and river, our disadvantage, geographically speaking, will be our advantage. If we have so many creeks all over the city, then we have so many catch basins. I don't know if I'm being logical. Creeks are natural catch basin of water. But how come our road is full of water an hour or two, but our river is not? So I don't know, there must be something wrong or disconnect somewhere else. Your roads are full of water, 2 feet deep. And when you go and check the creek, it is in a normal level. So that's why I told the, there must be something wrong. So I need a thorough study, no infrastructure development yet, just thorough study, so that when we align or build underground, like sewage system, drainage system, we build it with the it's like building a house. You don't just build the wall, you build first what's inside the wall before it's being covered. So it's the same thing with the water. So I'm really interested in the long term solution. That's the word. Basic. You see, I don't think that we have a plan, like a 10-year plan with the drainage system or 5-year plan. It's just that, oh, there's flood there, oh, you check. You make this siphon it and or resize it. Or we just put the pump there. Keep in destroying roads, put up a new pipe, and throw it somewhere else. I think they're not intertwined. I don't know, I just don't know.
No, I think you know what you're doing. It's quite clear.
There are attributes that I cannot disagree. True, there are attributes. Climate change, world, that's a world problem. Two, this is a highly urbanized city. There's too many concrete, less trees. So there's less trees, less absorption, basic science. And we are the located west of Metro. So any water coming from the east, geographically speaking, everybody will go to Manila because we have the delta, what they call the passing river. See? So these are already facts of life of Manila. Okay, having said that, I cannot do and change Manila's location. That is literally impossible. I can do something with trees to create more green, to absorb more water on a regular rainy days all over the city. So we have a goal to be 1,600 hectares of green open space to be called as green. Anong tawag doon sa category ng DNA?
Healthy and ecologically balanced.
Healthy and ecologically balanced, highly urbanized city of Manila. If we achieve that, we will have that under that category. And that can be done. It's not a rocket science, planting trees. It's just that maximizing open space, putting more trees and green. Okay. So that we can do. Drainage system, yes, we can do. Why? we have a yearly fund for infrastructure development. We have, but the thing is, there's no direction. We just build here, build there. The mayor thought of, I want to build here. Or the Paluing man, they start building. See, that's why I think we're losing time. That's one of the most valuable commodity in this world. That's my personal opinion. I can always lose money, I can get that money, but we lose time, we lose opportunity. That's why it's very expensive. You cannot even buy back 1 second of your life. Then, if we have this plan, so let's just say X amount of billions of pesos, how will plot it? Plot it in the plan? Or how much kilometer of drainage system that I can build with this money based on this? So I know. Come, public forum, maybe public will ask, oh, how long you're going to solve flooding in the city? Oh, because of that massive plan. Or I think with the continuing leadership, with the continuing policy, we can address it in the next 22 years. At least you have a group. That's what they did in Malaysia. Kuala Lumpur. They can resolve flooding in urban setting. So what did they build a catch basin? And they helped so many, naturally. Malaysia built, engineering-wise, the tunnel. Yeah. But I have so many, that's why naturally, Manila is very rich with nature, with water, culture, and heritage. And maybe you can have a solution. So yeah, that's the specific that when I was asked, what do you want us to do? No, I want you to start it. I want to resolve flooding, not even in my time. Put the fundament. So that I will know when one time, given a chance, oh, Mr. Moreno, how many kilometers, if you ask me now, if this is examination, Mr. Moreno, how many kilometers of drainage system you have in the city of Manila? Next question, please. See, that's how we are going to look stupid. To some, this is petty. This is what you call governance. So I don't know if I'm guessing. Your choice to succeed. But one thing for sure, we are going now to ABCs of problem. I went back to A.
Yes.
Start basics. All over again. From zero. Zero. Whatever is there is considered zero. Then you start giving back roads. Maintain, sustain, duplicate the same policy last July. Duplicate. Now we're going to peripherals. We took and confronted the biggest challenge. If we will succeed, I told them, I always said, if we are going to succeed in this challenge, nothing is impossible already in the city. So better fail here or succeed here.
We wish you all the best.
Oh, thank you.
We are ready. mean, we can't do a geospatial survey of Middle Earth. We can do that without the US.
Wow. Ayun, gusto ko yun, geospatial. Wow. Galing nun. Well, I don't know with others if they understand how to use geospatial. That's good. No? That's
we have little pockets of expertise which we are happy to work with.
We're regularly in touch with the public policy of the US.
Yeah, public policy. We have the Center of Liverpool Cities. We have companies, whether it's drainage, flood management, BUV does it, traffic management, SD engineering has the technology in place. You talk about your self-driving vehicles, all these things. But I mean, you have to see whether what works for you, because you can't just blindly apply whatever is out there.
I don't like shotgun.
Yes.
I really don't like shotgun. Shotgun approach.
Study first. So what's your problem? Then plan.
I really don't like it. I would rather go surgical and slow moving. At least we can only we achieve this. Because I always believe in the principle of temperature. Everything above zero is possible. Rather, it may look fast, but it's actually slow. Focus. That's why. While we wait for other things, plan for other things.
And of course, before I end, personally, we really wish you success.
Thank you.
We are living in this city, and whatever you do to make it more livable and better, you benefit as residents. Thank you very much.
We will now invite you to Bulwaga.
The
key to the situation.
We're the key to the situation.
Assistant, yung babae. Yung babae, yung ambassador. Yung Singaporean. Ano yung name ng katipin mo na lang?
Deputy Chief of Mission.
Ah, Deputy Chief of Mission.
Deputy Chief of Mission yung lalaki sa political attaché.
Ah, political attaché. Hmm.
Bale. Mayos ka nga, bale. Siniksik mo lahat kami.
No, but you.
libre.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Dito po. Here. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Yes, sir, like.
I here. Here. K123. Thank you.
Nina. Yeah, I do.
Reference materials.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Oh, there.
You might not even do this, not even Kailangan.
It's been affecting a lot of urban problems, whether it's traffic, whether it's sewage, whether it's drainage, and even higher tech stuff. Because today we talked about digital governance and so forth. So there are all these things out there, and these are things that Singapore as a country, Singapore as a city, we'd like to share with all our friends and whoever's interested in looking at these things. So what basically I had spoken to Mayor today was just to offer him the opportunity. If he so wishes, we can always arrange a study visit to Singapore to look at some of these things. The Mayor has talked about attending the World Cities Summit, which is an annual gathering of cities around the world, where mayors get to exchange their ideas for tackling problems in the city.
Just to clarify, Singapore's assistance will be in the form of a study grant instead of financial?
I think we have to look, Singapore as a government, we don't do financial grants per se. We do a lot of what we call technical assistance and training and study visits and so forth. And Mayor Moreno, he picks up that this often won't be the first. We had worked with Jakarta before, but I only recall Jakarta because my last posting. But we do this in general. I don't have the details.
Sir, just to put context of the assistance, why is it important for Singapore to help
develop Manila? Well, I think if you have done something before and it seems to work, and you want to be a good neighbor and a good friend to your region and people around you, you've got a good story to tell. I think isn't it good to share these things with everyone? Yeah.
So just a clarification, the blueprint, you were going to give us an existing study or a blueprint? What does it amount to?
No, no,
was not giving any blueprint of study. I was because I think the mayor was referring to doing a comprehensive study on the city of Manila. So I said, you know, Singapore government actually doesn't won't be able. We are not the U.S. government. We can't do a big geospatial study of the city of Manila. Well, there are engineering solutions. There are commercial companies that we have that do these things, and we have talked and done feasibility studies on doing traffic management, installing intelligent traffic management systems in the Philippines before. I'm not an engineer, I'm not from the company, I don't know what is their exact solution, but we have done it in Singapore, and we can do it if there's a desire to do so here as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.